Hi and welcome. I am Shatakshi, co-founder of Global Governance Initiative and a management consultant with Boston Consulting Group. I'm a graduate from Indian School of Business, ISB Hyderabad, and did my undergraduate from St. Stephen's College. Welcome to yet another show of the GGI podcast. In this podcast, I will be answering a very specific question that I have received from, honestly, plethora of undergraduate candidates and undergraduate students from so many prestigious universities in India while we were conducting masterclasses on ground as well as now online in an interactive ecosystem. Okay, coming to the point, what is the key question? The key question is, Shatakshi, should I do my MBA right after my undergraduate degree? That is the question that I have received so many times, and honestly, I have a very strong stance on this one. The answer is, in my view, no, you should not go ahead and get yourself enrolled in an MBA program right after your undergraduate degree. Now, in a true consultant fashion, I believe there are three reasons in my view why I say so. Let's get started with the first one. Number one, what is your end goal after you are doing so? Because you want growth in your professional career, right? What is the end goal? For, I would say, 90 to 95% of the students, it's getting a job. And of course, we have outliers, and those are my favorite outliers, people who want to get started with their own venture with the aid of academic institution. Okay, let's come back to the people of who are comprising 85 to 95% of my set, people who want to get a job. If you go directly from an undergraduate institution, and there are so many types of such undergraduate institution to an MBA program, the probability of you cracking a job compared to your peers really goes down. Employers these days are definitely looking for people who have had some hands-on experience through not only an internship, but a proper full-time job. So that's definitely one of the key reasons why you should be looking to work sometime, work and get some quality experience after your undergraduate degree. So that's my point number one. Point number two is the MBA curriculum is very practically designed curriculum, which is something that many, many people miss out on, right? Right from your courses like statistics, operations. We used to have this popular course on DMOP and ISB, marketing, product, etc. You will not be able to appreciate, you will not be able to understand the insight and the value through that curriculum if you go right after your undergraduate degree in, let's say, civil engineering or science or arts to a B school. You will not be able to understand the why, the what, and it will be pretty tricky if you want to understand the how part of it. Now, you may say, Shatakshi, curriculum is not really important, but I would then ask you to hold on. This is not like, sorry to stereotype, but IIT, where you end up studying civil engineering and then you probably join a consulting firm or a product role. In MBA, the curriculum is pretty pragmatic, and in fact, it's expected out of you to know your content really very well. So that's the second point. You will not be able to appreciate and get the insight if you are going to an MBA program right after your college. That brings me to the last point, which is the most important one, in fact, in my opinion, is the value of experimenting. And like Michelle Obama says, swerving in life. Do not be that robot who goes from point X to point Y and eventually at the age of 26 and 27 question that, oh my God, I'm having quarter life crisis and I don't know what do I want to do in life, and then basically Googling how to find your passion in life, right? That's a very, very scary situation to be in. We as millennials, we are really questioning hard the IIMs of the world. Is it the right spot? We're in fact really questioning the value of higher ed in terms of academic institutions, right? And I would not give a comment on if it's really good or if it's really bad in terms of the academic institutions we have in India and globally. But what I'm trying to say is it's nice, especially when you are 19 or 20 and you would want to experiment. And by experiment, I mean that you go on take that content development job, you go on and take that crazy marketing job that you have been dreaming about. I know especially the trying and the unfortunate circumstances we are in, you might say or question, but Shatakshi, I want a job. I'm not able to have it. So what next? Should I not apply for an MBA then? But you really need to question, if you go in such not so lucrative background, and even if you get into an MBA program, it's going to be pretty hard for you after 2 years to get that job, right? So do not be focused on the short-term gains that you get out of the admission, or that admission letter that you get, the kick out of it. What's really important is, are you keeping that long-term horizon in mind or not? So yes, that's my stance on why you should not go ahead and join MBA right after completing your undergraduate degree. And that's the end of this GGI podcast show. We look forward to having you here on many other questions that I will be addressing, that I have witnessed from so many talented people, as I've been on ground in India and met so many youngsters through our GGI masterclass. Bye-bye and take care.